The Children's Television Workshop presents Sesame Street Show 446, produced in color with Teletape, New York.
Sure, the whole place looks nice. Boy, sometimes it's slow doing all that work. You know, slow. You know the difference between slow and fast, don't you? I'm sure you do. But if you want, I could show you. You know, let me show you. This will be fun anyway. See, I have my toy box here, and I'll use that to show you. First, I'll dump out my toys. There. Now, let me put all the toys back in, and I'll show you. Put my kitty in. And my bus. My cowboy hat. And, mustn't forget my ducky. There. Now, get them all back in the box. Whew! There. Now that's a slow way to do it. Hope I dropped my ducky. Okay, see? Now that was slow. Now there's a much faster way of doing it. Now I'm going to show you that way now. Watch this. There. That was fast.
Sleep. At last. Well, what's that? A fly. Chicken. What's that? A drum playing rabbit. Out.
Bert! Oh, Bert! Bert. Hey, Bert, listen. Listen, Bert, you got to come quick out into the kitchen, Bert, because something terrible's happened out in the kitchen. You got to come out into the kitchen, Bert.
Slow down,
quick,
Ernie.
Bert.
Ernie. No, wait. See, I can't understand a word you're saying. You're talking too fast. Just slow down.
Yes, Bert, but you got to come real quick out into the kitchen here, Bert, because
No, Ernie. I still can't understand you. Just talk slow. Real slow now, okay?
Okay.
Okay, now.
But what I wanted to tell you is that the bread, that you put in the toaster is burning, Bert.
My bread is burning?
Yeah.
Oh, Ernie, why didn't you tell me sooner? Oh, my bread. Oh, look at all that bread. It's all ruined. Ernie, my bread is ruined.
Wait a second.
Smoke
wait a second,
on toast
Bert.
And look what
you
got. What?
Bert, stop. What? You gotta talk slower. I can't understand you, Bert.
It's an insult, I tell you. Look, I'm a fly. Fly begins with this letter, F. Trouble is, frog begins with F, too. But while flies are very handsome, frogs are fat and ugly. Therefore, I claim it's beneath my dignity as a fly to have to appear here to talk about the letter F with this.
Ribbit.
This is the capital letter A. Next to it is the small letter A. Many words begin with this letter. Alligator, for instance. An alligator is an American reptile, similar to the crocodile, but having a shorter and flatter head.
They have also been known to be extremely dangerous.
This is a cuckoo clock. It's called that because every hour a cuckoo bird comes out of this little door and tells you what time it is. Like now, it's almost 3 o'clock, so very soon the little cuckoo bird will say cuckoo 3 times.
Excuse me, Mac.
Sorry.
Just step aside there.
Oopsie daisy. Thanks, pal.
Hey, watch your toes.
Come
there.
Come on, sorry.
Excuse me, Mac.
Cuckoo.
That's one.
Cuckoo.
Two.
Cuckoo.
Three.
Sorry. Come on. Hey, look out.
See you in an hour.
3 cuckoo birds.
Phew. How come you wanted me to come way up here, little Grover monster buddy?
Well, Bird, see, what happened was I was playing with my airplane, and now it's stuck up there.
I flew it too high.
How'd you get it way out there,
and
boy?
I cannot reach it, and I thought maybe you could reach it for me.
Well, Grover.
Yes.
You asked the right bird.
Oh, good. Go ahead.
Because I am so big. I have a long, long neck. I can reach out and get it.
Okay, do it for me. Go ahead. Get it?
Well.
A little more. A little more.
I'm trying, but it's almost.
You can't do it either.
Right, get it.
Oh, big bird. You know, I can just begin to do it, and you can almost do it. Hey, what if we did it together? Maybe we could get it then.
You mean cooperate?
Yeah.
Oh, sure. Well, I know then.
What?
Since I can almost reach it,
yeah?
And you can just begin to. If you were sitting on my beak,
yeah?
You could reach out and grab it.
Yes, I could.
Okay,
hey,
well,
that's good.
You'll have to shinny out there then.
Okay.
But be careful, it's a long drop.
Yes, I know. Okay, you go ahead and try and reach it, and I will try
and
climb up.
Sure you want to do this?
Yeah, you go ahead. Okay. I'll climb up over here. Okay, here we go.
Okay. You're tickling.
Well, your feathers are tickling me.
Oh, careful.
Okay, I'm coming along your back now.
Okay.
Coming along your neck.
Mm-hmm. Oh, ouch.
Oh, sorry, excuse me. I did not mean that.
Ow.
You all right?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, this is scary.
Okay. Don't break my feathers.
Sorry about that. Okay.
Ooh.
This is more difficult than I thought.
Oh, yeah.
Now hold up your beak. Mm. That's it. Okay, I think I
am. Grover!
I'm
gonna sneeze!
No! I will hold your beak. I'll hold your beak.
Yeah.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, shh. Okay. Okay, here we go. I got it now!
Grover! Hey, Grover, are you all right down there?
Oh, Birdie.
Yes, Grover?
Birdie. Would you like to hear something my mommy used to tell me many, many times when I was a little bitty baby monster?
Oh, yes. What did she tell you, Grover?
Well, Grover, she used to say, Grover, never sneeze when somebody is standing on your beak!
But you don't have a beak, Grover.
But you do!
I'll try to remember that.
Hello there, Kermit the Frog here, and today I'm going to demonstrate my new invention, the What Happens Next machine. Now, the What Happens Next machine, its purpose is to turn on my radio. I will show you. Over here is my radio. This stuff here is not my radio, it's part of the machine, but right here is the radio, you see? Now, I'm going to turn on this radio using the principle of What Happens Next, okay? Now, I will next demonstrate how this machine is going to go about doing its job. Note this rope. See this rope right here? This rope goes up into the air and across there and down to that sandbag. See the sandbag? Okay. Now, first of all, I'm going to cut this rope. Now, when I cut the rope, what happens next is that the sandbag is going to fall down and land on this end of the seesaw. See that? Okay. What happens next is this end of the seesaw goes down, which means that this end of the seesaw over here goes up, okay? So what happens next is this rope right here, which is tied to the lid of this box, is going to make the box open, okay? So what will happen next is this balloon, which is inside the box, see the balloon? This balloon is going to go up into the air. And you will note that the balloon is tied to the switch of the radio. So when the balloon goes up into the air, it's going to turn on the radio. See that? Okay. Now see, it used to be that I used to have to walk all the way over there to turn my radio on. I did indeed. It would tire out my feet. It would waste time. But not anymore, thanks to the magic of What Happens Next. And now, for the first time anywhere, the Kermit What Happens Next machine. First of all, I'm going to cut the rope, which is going to drop the sandbag. And here we go. I cut the rope. And what happens next is the sandbag is pretty, I guess there's some sort of a tangle or something up there. So I guess what happens next when you got a tangled rope is nothing. So we'll just skip the sandbag portion of my invention and get right on with the seesaw portion. Now I'm going to give the seesaw here a push. Well, I guess The seesaw seems to be stuck here. So what happens next is that we ignore the stuck seesaw, and we'll move right over here to the box. And what do you bet the lid won't open? Let's see. Okay, and now we raise the lid of the box. Hey, there you go. And what happens next is a balloon is going to float up into the air, and it's going to turn on the switch of the radio. Come on, balloon. Hey, balloon. I'll give it a couple of kicks. Hey, listen. Listen, you balloon. I've had enough trouble today. You float up in that air right now, or I won't be responsible for what happens next. Hey, there you have it. A masterful invention when I get it all working. A chain of what happens nexts, which will enable me to turn on my radio from all the way over here. And I don't have to worry now about where I am. I don't have to worry about where my radio is ever again, because I know that what happens next is... what happens next is that I have to get another radio.
F. Flower. Oh, that smells beautiful.
Flower? F?
I am a problem solver. You know, I am so sick and tired of people always dumping trash on top of my head, thinking that this is the trash can, you know, but this is my home. So I made this sign, see? And I'm going to put it right here, and it points over there to that trash can where they're supposed to dump it. See? Right down there. It says, dump trash here. Now, if I could just hang it here, let's see if I just nailed it there, I think it's going to be all right. Yeah, I'll have to go get my hammer. Well, I'll set it up here for now until I get my hammer. Okay.
Gators and alligators. Oh, dump trash here. Right.
Lower.
Now, you know, after a meal like that, the best thing to do is to go out and take a good, brisk walk.
Oh, all right. You want to take a walk?
Sure.
Sure, we can go for a walk now, Ralph. Good. We better put our jackets on, though, so we don't get cold.
Good idea. Right. Wait a second. Wally, we've got a problem here. Well, which one of these jackets is yours?
Well, I know. My jacket is the one that isn't yours. That's right.
Wally!
What?
Which one is that?
Well, I remember. My jacket had blue and white stripes.
Blue and white stripes? Mm-hmm. Oh, wait a minute. A blue stripe? A white stripe? Must be your jacket. There
oh, sure.
The white stripes.
Thanks, Ralph. Well, that settles that, huh?
Sure does.
Okay.
Wait a minute, Wally. We've got a problem because, see this jacket here? It has blue and white stripes, too.
Oh, yes. So is this one.
Yes, what's that? Oh,
that one's just like this one, then, huh? They both have blue and white stripes.
Isn't that nice? Wait a minute. Wait a minute, I remember that my jacket happened to have three shiny silver buttons right up the front, and there they are.
Uh-huh.
One, two, three.
Three silver buttons. Well, then that one must be yours, all right.
I think so.
Okay, that settles that.
Proves it. But,
Ralph, my jacket, look. It's got three nice shiny silver buttons, too. Gee, they're just as nice and big and shiny as yours. In fact, they're the same buttons.
Well, isn't that amazing? These jackets are exactly alike. Exactly alike. We're never going to be able to tell which one is yours
and
which one is mine.
Wait a minute, Ralph. Wally has an idea. You know what I did this morning? You know what?
What?
I made a jelly sandwich, and I put my jelly sandwich in the pocket. Here it is.
Oh.
There it is, so this one must be mine.
Wally, for a minute there, I thought you really had something. I thought you had a clue to tell you which jacket was yours and which one was mine. But no such luck, because this morning I made a jelly sandwich, and there it is.
A jelly sandwich.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we're never going to be able to figure out which jacket is which then.
I guess not. Well, we might as well just put on the jackets and go out for a walk.
Oh, well, I mean, okay, we might as well, huh?
A nice, brisk walk.
At least we won't be cold.
Oh, sirree. Not with us. Wally.
What's the matter?
Hey, Wally, this jacket seems to be very big on me.
It does?
Yeah, very big.
Oh, that's strange, because you know what?
What?
This jacket seems very small on me.
Wait a minute.
What?
That jacket is very small on you, right?
Right.
This jacket is very big on me, right?
That's right.
Well, you know what that means,
what?
Don't you?
What?
It means that when we go out for a walk, we're going to have to buy ourselves some new jackets.
Oh, that's good.
Okay, Ralph.
Well, that's a good idea. Boy, yes.
Whee!
to imagine you're somebody else, like a doctor or a pilot or a cowboy.
Yeah, and wouldn't it be fun to be a ship captain or a scientist or an acrobat?
But you know, whenever I get to thinking it'd be nicer to be somebody else, I remind myself how nice it is just to be me. Me. Everything I am is me. Everything I see is me in my mirror, me in my bed, me in the pictures I make in my head. Me. What a thing to be is me. Utterly delicious, and since there's no choice, I am sure I and me agree. There's nobody better, sweeter, nicer, smarter, don't you see, than me.
You know, sometimes I remind myself how nice it is to be me, but I remind myself in Spanish. Want to hear?
Sure.
Yo, todo lo que es yo. Todo lo que soy es yo, mi reflejo, yo en el espejo, yo y lo que pasa en mi cabeza, yo. Lo que quiero ser es yo, guapo, formidable y tan buen mozo que estarás de acuerdo. No existe nadie más guapo y cariñoso, ya lo ves, que yo.
It's nice being us, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure is.
Slow. Fast. Slow. Fast. Slow.
This is a small A, and this is a small story using A words. An ape wearing an apron ate a lot of air and got an ache. Along came a bird and gave aid to the ape.
Thank you very much.
And they lived to a ripe old age. Now that's what I call a story.
There. Oh, Mr. Hooper.
Yes, Cookie Monster.
There. Me all finished wiping off the counter for you.
Thank you very much.
Mr.
You
Hooper.
You did a good job, yes?
Thank you. Me do you a favor, now you do me a favor.
Like what?
Well, you see, Mr. Hooper, me not know how to count backwards from 10 to 1. You help me?
Sure. You know how to count forwards?
Oh, yeah. Pretty
yes?
good.
Yes?
Listen, 1.
Mm-hmm.
2.
Yes.
3.
Good.
4.
Yeah.
5.
Uh-huh.
6.
Good.
6. 7. Yes. 8.
Yeah.
9. 10.
Marvelous.
Yeah.
There
me
you
do
are.
That forwards, but me know how to count backwards.
Well, to count backwards, all you have to do is do the same thing, but do it backwards. Start with 10.
Oh, start 10 and go backwards.
Right.
Okay. 10.
Mm-hmm.
9. Mm-hmm. 8.
Yes.
Yeah. 7.
That's right.
7.
Yes.
7. 6.
Mm-hmm.
5.
Good. Marvelous.
We forget the rest.
Three. Two.
Yeah.
One.
Oh, see, me no can do it. Me forget. Me yeah. No can count backwards. Me give
you
up.
You can do it. You can. I have an idea.
What?
I have an idea how you can do it.
What?
What are these?
Those cookies.
Right.
Oh, now, boy.
I'm going to put them down here.
Yeah.
Huh? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 9, 10. Right?
Oh, yeah.
Now, count them backwards.
Oh, count cookies backwards.
Yes.
Okay, let's see. 10.
Yeah.
9.
Yes.
8.
Uh-huh.
7.
Uh-huh.
Excuse me while talking with wooden mouth. Oh, got that early. 6.
Right.
5.
Uh-huh.
Oh, 4. Three.
Yes.
2. 1.
Cookie Mutz, that wasn't hard, was it?
Mr. Hooper?
What?
Not only it's not hard.
Yes.
It's delicious.
Waiter!
Yes, sir. This is Grover, your waiter. May I help you? Before you decide what you want to eat, would you take a look at our special of the day?
Yes, that looks delicious. I would like a sandwich just like the one in the picture.
Excellent choice, sir.
Yes. But waiter,
yes.
Would you hurry, please? I don't have much time.
Yes, sir. I'll rush order on this special there, Charlie.
Hello there. Yes, Grace. Yes. Nice day.
Oh, you will love this, sir. There you are, the special.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Just a minute, waiter.
Yes, sir?
Nope. Look at the picture. See on the picture?
Yeah.
The picture has potato chips, but there are no potato chips on my sandwich. Forgot the potato chips.
Oh, what a mistake. Sir, I shall get you some potato chips right away. Would you look at the paintings on the wall?
Oh, would you please
right
hurry, waiter?
Yes, sir, hurry. Tony,
same thing every day. I don't know why I come in this place. Oh, well.
Okay, here we go, sir.
Oh, thank goodness.
There you are.
Now, just a minute. Let me check it out. Okay. Nope.
One, no.
Look at the picture.
Yeah.
It's still not right. See, on the picture, there's a pickle. But on my sandwich, there is no pickle. Nope, it's wrong.
I cannot argue with you, sir. You are absolutely correct. I will have to get you another, not another sandwich. This is a good sandwich, isn't it?
Would you go get the pickle on my sandwich?
Charlie, getting mad at me.
Oh, my goodness. Same thing every day. I only have a few minutes left.
I'm sorry, sir. This is my second day here, and I'm kind of nervous. I don't know what to do. Okay. Yes, sir. How'd you like that?
Okay, sir. Let me check it out.
Yes.
Nope, this sandwich is not the same sandwich that's in the picture here. Look at the picture.
Yeah,
see?
Yeah.
You left off the olive. There's an olive in the picture, but no olive on my sandwich.
Yes, sir. I'm going to get you a new olive. Okay. He would have to like olives. All right, Charlie, you forgot the olive.
Please hurry. Oh, dear. I don't know.
I think we have the problem solved. Sir, I think that is complete, but would you please check it because I'm too nervous.
Yes, let me check it with the picture.
I'm very nervous, please.
Let's see. There's the potato chips.
I hope it's right.
On the plate. Potato chips in the picture. Pickle in the picture and pickle on the plate. Olive in the picture and olive on my sandwich.
Yes, yes.
Just perfect.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, it's perfect.
Good.
Well, goodbye.
What? Goodbye, sir? What?
Well, my lunch hour's over. I don't have time to eat it now. See you tomorrow.
Ah, Charlie, I quit! I'm not gonna take any more.
F. Fly.
Hurry, step right up. C.T. Wordsworth here to show you what it is and where it's at with words. Big ones, small ones, fat ones, and tall ones. And today's word is...
bird.
That is correct. B-I-R-D.
Bird.
Do you know you're a bird?
Hum a few bars. I'll see if I can pick it up. Gotcha.
Okay, hit it.
Bird.
F. Listen now to the letter F.
F.
Because in the next few fragments, the letter F will be featured.
F.
This is my fantastic flea circus, featuring the fabulous flea family, Freddy, Fats, Fanny, Filbert, and Floyd Flea.
Floyd has the flu.
Flu?
So Fats will fill in for Floyd.
Fine.
But make it fast, because Fats has a 5 o'clock flight to Finland.
Let's feature Fats first on the format, then. Fire away, Fats!
First, I fly the flag. Then a flute fanfare. Then I do a flying flip. Oh, I fractured my foot.
Now featuring Freddy and Fanny Flea firing the field cannon on Fort Fumter.
Freddy and Fanny are feuding and refuse to perform.
Find Filbert to fill in.
I'm Filbert.
Listen, Filbert, you follow Fats and fire on the fort.
Fine, fine. First, I put the flame to the fuse and...
Filbert, you fool.
Oh, fooey.
Anybody want to buy a used F?
I'm going to paint a 10. Let's see, where can I paint a 10? Aha! My 10. My 10. My 10's gone.
And now it's time for everybody's favorite wacky stunt show, Beat the Time. And here's your host, Guy Smiley.
And now let's meet today's first contestant, Mr. Cookie Monster from Sesame Street. Come on out. Hi,
Hi, Guy.
Are you ready for your wacky stunt?
Me no know. If me do it, what me win?
You will win a cookie.
Cookie?
Yes, yes. Let go of me, Cookie Monster. Yes, all you have to do, listen closely.
Yeah, me listening.
You have to find three things.
Yeah.
That's three things.
Three things.
That rhyme with the word rain.
Three things that rhyme with word rain.
You got it. But you've got to do it before the arrow on our clock reaches zero.
Oh-ho.
Okay? Ready? Get set? Go!
When do we start?
You start now!
Go!
Will he do it? Cookie Monster has got to find three things. That's three things that rhyme with the word rain.
Cane!
Wonderful, wonderful, Cookie Monster. That's one thing that rhymes with the word rain. Now you've got to find two more.
Hey, a big blue monster just stole my cane.
Listen, we're doing a television show here right now, sir. I'm sorry.
Hey, are you guys Smiley?
Yes, but you've got to get off the stage
Beat the Time?
Yes, it is, but we're playing the game here, and Cookie Monster's got to find two more things that rhyme with the word rain.
Chain!
Wonderful, Cookie Monster. That's two things that rhyme with the word rain.
Me go find one more thing.
One more thing you've got to find. What's at the end of this chain? Well, listen, I'm sorry, but you got to get off right now because we're playing the game. Get off. Because Cookie Monster
guy,
only has...
Guy, me go find nothing.
You got to find something.
Turn around behind you.
No, you're
over here. What rhyme with rain? Me go find nothing.
Think of something.
Me got it.
Yeah? What can he do? His time is over. There's only a few seconds left. Can he do it in time? Wait a minute. What's that sound? It can't be. It sounds like... Oh, no.
Train. Train rhyme with rain. Me win cookie.
You certainly do. Here's your cookie, Cookie Monster.
Thank you.
You win the shot.
You took my choo-choo train!
Can you get this train out of the studio?
Autograph, Mr. Smiley!
All aboard for Noah, Chico, and Coca Manga! And me what?
Let's get down here!
All aboard!
Get a nice
break! All right, give me a ticket! Don't cry, don't push! Get off the train!
Oh, I'm sorry. This is the capital letter A. Next to it is the small letter A. Many words begin with this letter. Alligator, for instance. An alligator is an American reptile, similar to the crocodile, but having a shorter and flatter head.
They have also been known to be extremely dangerous.
Ernie, I'm tired of that program, Ernie. Hey, let's turn it off, okay? Ernie, I think it's time to have a talk about taking turns. I mean, you know, you've been watching TV for a long time, and I want to listen to a record.
Shh! Come on, Bert, can't you see I'm trying to watch TV? Come on.
Okay, smart guy. You watch your old TV. I'm going to play a record anyhow.
Look at that. Hey! Hey, Bert! Hey, I can't hear the TV with the record going. Okay. You want to play a record? See if you can hear your record with the radio going.
Aha! Okay, smart guy. See if you like this over here.
Sure.
How about that?
blew a fuse.
Oh, well, don't just stand there talking about it. You were the one that had the bright idea to, you know, turn on the dumb mixer. What are we going to do now?
I have an idea. You go around and turn off all the things we turn on, and I'll try and fix a fuse.
Okay. Let's see. Let's see the television set's over here. Let's see the mixer was over here somewhere. Let's see the radio was here. And let's see. Oh, the phonograph is back here. There.
Yeah. Hey, how about we play a game of cards together?
Okay, good idea, Bert.
Yeah.
Let me get them. Okay.
Yeah, I'm sorry about, you know, the record player and all, Ernie.
Yeah. Well, I'm sorry about, you know, watching television that much, too, so.
Well, I'm really sorry about the mixer here. That was rough.
Well, I'm sorry about the radio, too, you know.
Well, I'm sorry about interrupting you watching television.
You know, well, we shouldn't really, you know, try to do things like that, I guess.
No,
you know.
I'm really sorry about all...
Bald Eagle. These are the curly highways. Now he's looking at a road. Now he's looking at the big cliff with the road next to it. The bridge with a river going under it. A curly road.
A funny one, too.
Yeah. Oh, now he's in this nest again.
F. Flower. Oh, that smells beautiful. Flower? F?
Hi. Yeah, I got something to tell you.
Tú puedes ser lo que quieras ser. Ir donde quieras ir y creer en ti, creyendo en ti. Puedes ir donde quieras ir, hacer lo que quieras, sí, creyendo en ti, creyendo en ti. Some folks try to tell you there are things you shouldn't do, 'cause you're not strong enough or smart enough at all.
Yeah.
But what seems right to them quite often might be wrong for you. So be sure you try to climb before you get too scared you'll fall. You can be what you want to be, learn what you want to learn. Believe in yourself, just believe in yourself. Everybody over here, you can try what you want to try. No one should question why. Believe in yourself, just believe in yourself. Folks will say you're different, that you've gone and lost your senses, but the world is yours to walk in. Go ahead and leap the fences, and you'll see. Believe in yourself, and the world belongs to you and to me. Hey, let's do that again. Follow the leader. Oh, you can be what you want to be. Learn what you want to learn. Believe in yourself. Yay, believe in yourself. Oh, you can try what you need to try. No one should question why. Believe in yourself. Just believe in yourself. Folks will say you're different, that you've gone and lost your senses, but the world is yours to walk in. Go ahead, leap the fences, and you'll see. Believe in yourself, and the world belongs to you and to me. That's what I said.
they are, the alphabet dancers. What could they possibly do today? What? What is that? What are they doing? Twirling around. Tumbling, tumbling. They're on the ground. And now, ooh, she's got an itch. They've just made the letter F. F.
This is the letter F. And F sounds like this. You see that? Let's do it again. F sounds like this. Wow. Hey, let's do it again, okay? F sounds like this. Uh-oh. I wish I hadn't done that.
Hey, you want to have some fun?
Sure.
Look, see those kids over there in the playground? I'll show you how things look when they go slow and fast.
Okay.
Go fast! Hey, wow!
Want to see the slow?
Sure. Okay, everybody, go slow!
We can make him go slow and fast. Let's try it.
Go fast, Big Bird!
Now go slow, Big Bird. Go slow.
Hey, there's nobody in it.
Let's get in it and see if we can make it go fast.
Go, go faster!
Faster! Hey! Hey, it's going too fast! Too fast! Slow it down!
Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. 10 tiny turtles on the telephone, talking with the grocery men. We would like some lettuce. Will you send us pinheads, please? And 10 sweet potatoes and 10 rutabagas with the dimples on their knees. And send us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 artichokes. 10 eggplants, over easy. That's one of our little jokes. 10 leafy, leafy collard greens, and please make sure they're washed. Light up our eyes, brighten our lives with 10 banana squash. We'll need 10 cans of black-eyed peas. They give you good, strong muscles. 10 of those tasty sprouts, the ones that they call Brussels. We'd also like 10 mangoes. They're the favorite of our sister Gert. And one last thing, please do include 10 apples for dessert.
10.
Do you know the alphabet? You know the alphabet. I know the alphabet, too. I know it starts with A, and then I get lost. Can you help me? What happens after A?
B.
B, and then after that?
C.
Yeah.
D.
Yeah.
E.
Yeah.
F.
Yeah. What comes after F? What comes after F? I know what comes after F. You ready? Oh, yeah. What's that?
G.
Ah, G comes after F. What comes after G?
I think I have another answer. How about that? What's that?
H.
H. Very good. Okay. Then what? H. I. J. Then what? K.
L.
L. Yeah? I know it's not easy.
M.
Hmm?
M.
L. M. N.
O.
O. O. O. O. What comes after O? O. We can do it. We can do it. What comes after O?
P.
P. P. Very good. P.
Q.
Q. R. R. Is that right? R. And
S.
S. S.
T.
T.
U.
U. We're getting there. What comes after you? V. V comes after you. U, V.
W.
W.
X.
X. I think we're going to do it. What comes next?
Y.
And then what?
Z.
Oh, we did it.
It's an insult, I tell you. Look, I'm a fly. Fly begins with this letter, F. Trouble is, frog begins with F, too. But while flies are very handsome, frogs are fat and ugly. Therefore, I claim it's beneath my dignity as a fly to have to appear here to talk about the letter F with this...
Ribbit.
Almost up there. Well, there I am. Next time I will lose my airplane on this pole because I know how to climb it. Yeah. Sesame Street. Oh, what a nice view. Oh, that reminds me. Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters A and F. And by the number 10. Yeah. Bye-bye.
Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. Bye-bye.